and the Sisters of Mercy, induct new ambassadors, and honor the graduating ambassadors. We would like to thank you for celebrating this special occasion with all of us. Now, if you would please welcome Mercer's University Chaplain, Father Jim Pisker, as he will lead us in prayer.
Let us pray. Gracious God, in the Gospels we are called by Jesus to be salt and light, to expend ourselves on behalf of others in the ordinariness of life. In these young women and men we celebrate today, we acknowledge their role as ambassadors for Mercyhurst University. But more importantly, we recognize their willingness to expend themselves on behalf of others as ministers of hospitality and living witnesses of your charge. Knowing that you are with us in this gathering, open our hearts and minds to that which we are called to know and to be through our presence here. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
It is now my pleasure to introduce Mercer's University's 12th president, President Michael T. Victor.
Thank you.
invite Vice President of Enrollment, Joe Howard, to speak on the role of an ambassador.
Thank you, Lynn. Good afternoon, everyone. Before I begin my remarks, I want to acknowledge we have some special guests in attendance this afternoon. First, welcome to Mr. Ron Ramley, an alumnus from the class of 1997. Today's gathering represents the 25th annual Spring Tea and the founding of the Ambassadors. Ron played a key role in those early years and is one of the co-writers of the Ambassador song that you'll sing this later this afternoon. Ron, many thanks for traveling in for today's ceremony. Second, I want to thank Sister Rita Panciera for joining us. Sister Rita operates one of the local ministries of the Sisters of Mercy, the House of Prayer. Over the course of the last years, the Ambassadors have forged an ongoing and meaningful relationship with Sister Rita and her organization, and I'm very grateful that she made the time to attend today. Third, we have the honor of welcoming back to campus Sister Pat Whalen, the university's former registrar. Sister Pat retired from Mercyhurst 2 years ago to assume a leadership position with the regional community of the Sisters of Mercy as they consolidate their communities at a national level. Finally, good friend of the ambassadors, Erlene Glazier, the university's former archivist, is in attendance. Erlene also retired recently, and many of the ambassadors in the room relied on her support as they sought to learn more about the university's history. Can we give these four a round of applause? Thank you again for making the time to be here. There's an oft-cited analogy of Isaac Newton's that I like to use to frame this talk. And it's used to describe the way in which the Academy, the broad collection of colleges and universities across time and place, the way in which the Academy pursues its mission of knowledge creation. In a letter to his intellectual rival, Newton, a humble man, wrote, "If I have seen further, it is by standing on the shoulders of giants." Newton, of course, was acknowledging that his own theories of gravity and laws of motion were impossible absent the discoveries of the giants who preceded him. Without Copernicus and Galileo and Descartes, Newton's discoveries would have been impossible. His point was that knowledge progresses based on the incremental contributions of the forebears, the giants who preceded him. The Mercyhurst story, too, would be impossible absent the giants who preceded us. And while there are great men and giants whose contributions built our great university, the giants who I want each of you, ambassadors present and incoming, the giants I want you to be mindful of are the impressive women who founded an order and built our school. To today's inductees, it is this legacy of the women who you pledge as part of your oath to preserve and transmit to all those who come after you. To me, Mercyhurst remains one of the most unlikely stories in the unlikeliest of times. Consider the pioneering spirit of three women who came before us. First, there's Catherine McCauley, a devout Catholic and the founder of the Sisters of Mercy. After inheriting a fortune from a Quaker family, she uses the funds to open a charity, the House of Mercy, on Baggot Street in Dublin, Ireland. There, she allied with like-minded women to provide education and support to poor women and their children. Her charity was not without its naysayers, and over time, Catherine begins the process of founding a new religious community, the Sisters of Mercy. But the disorder of women religious would be, at Catherine's insistence, different from their contemporaries at the time. Catherine insisted that her sisters pledge an additional fourth vow of service and that they not observe the cloister, instead insisting that her sisters be permitted to leave the convent and minister directly to the people. The Sisters of Mercy are the first order of women religious to not observe a cloister. Next, we have Catherine's close friend, Frances Ward, the woman responsible for bringing mercy to the Americas. During her vocation, Frances founded communities of mercy in Ireland, in England, and in the States, foundational communities in Pittsburgh, Chicago, and Providence. Her leadership led to the creation of hundreds of health and educational ministries throughout the United States. So prolific and visionary was Frances that it is believed that she holds the historical record for the most religious communities and ministries founded by a single individual. Finally, there's the giant that is the Mercyhurst story, literally and figuratively, Mother M. Borgia Egan. Borgia was a woman of impressive stature, intellectual fortitude, vision, and earnestness. She and her pioneer sisters, 11 in total, struck out from Titusville, Pennsylvania to Erie, PA. They went door to door selling bonds and candy to raise funds for what they called at the time the Mercyhurst Project. Borgia crafted a vision of a magnificent structure, what we now know today as Old Main and Eaton Hall, that's visage would communicate grandeur, excellence, and aspiration. Borgia sent several of her peers off to university to obtain their PhDs, so that when she'd open her doors, she'd have a fully qualified faculty. When the construction workers went on strike shortly before Mercier's open, Borgia and her peers went to work assembling furniture, painting, and assembling doors, hanging doors, to ensure the school opened on schedule. As a testament to her conviction to excellence, Mercier's was one of the very first Catholic colleges to receive, in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, to receive an official charter from the PA Department of Education. Her steady and visionary leadership will carry Mercier's through a Great Depression and a World War, with Mercyhurst growing both in size and reputation despite those realities. These three women faced insurmountable odds in crafting their vision for a better world, a better nation, and a better future for higher education. So the title of this talk is The Role of Ambassadors. So what might all of this have to do with your role? Let's start with what ambassadors is not. You are not simply tour guides. Yes, you give tours, you open doors, and you welcome guests to our campuses. That work is how you make manifest your role, but that is not the full scope of your role. It is but a mere expression of that purpose. At his inauguration, President Victor chose the theme of renewal through mercy, doubling down on the values and vision of the Sisters of Mercy as central to his leadership philosophy. You and the role of ambassadors are central to that effort. Your role, your charge upon donning your green jacket and in perpetuity, is to capture, to preserve, to build on, and to pass on to future generations of Lakers the story, the legacy, and the traditions that you inherited from the giants that came before you. To be keepers of the Mercyhurst story. To be enthusiastic champions of the magic that is Mercyhurst. To share that spirit with those you encounter, be them peers or guests we're welcoming to campus. Quite simply, your role is to keep the Sisters' legacy alive in all we do. Today, that charge has a different sense of urgency. Next academic year will mark the first time that a Sister of Mercy has not had a full-time presence on our campus. Earlier this year, my friend and colleague on President Victor's cabinet, Sister Lisa Mary McCartney, Vice President for Mission Integration, announced her semi-retirement. Sister Lisa has worn many hats in her decades of service to Mercyhurst. And while I know this gesture will grate against her humble nature, I'd like to ask Sister Lisa to stand so that we may all have the honor of talking.
Good afternoon, and thank you all for being here.
being here to witness such an important and memorable Mercier's tradition. As Mercier's ambassadors, it is our duty to embrace and embody the spirit of the Sisters of Mercy. My fellow ambassadors can agree that being an ambassador is one of, if not the most, rewarding and important jobs that an undergraduate student can have on campus, as we are fortunate enough to help preserve much of the Mercier's tradition. That being said, the process that we went through to become the ambassador sitting before you today was one that required a lot of time, hard work, patience, and dedication. Luckily, ambassador pledges receive mentors to guide them through their pledging process. And this year, as the mentor chair, I had the pleasure of working with 17 outstanding mentors that helped shape the impressive pledge class sitting before you today. These mentors spent countless hours walking the tour route, listening to speeches, and giving advice, encouragement, and support to their pledges. Their passion for Mercyhurst and for the ambassador organization was evident in all of their work. And these 17 represent the qualities that all Mercyhurst ambassadors should strive to embody. Today, I would like to recognize these dedicated leaders and thank them for their contribution to the future of the Mercyhurst Ambassador Program. Mentors, when I say your name, if you could please stand, face the audience, and remain standing until all mentors have been recognized. Family and friends, please hold all applause until all 17 mentors have been named. I will now introduce our mentor committee for the pledge class of the 2017 and 2018 year. Lauren Abbott, Zachary Abadalo, Chandler Brendensis, Kristen Paraklis, Jennifer Hartwell, Robin Huber, Rachel Hull, Gabriella Massera, Caroline Mangano, Mitchell Marsh, Jackie Miller, Mark Mullinger, Cole Cross, Carrie Schroeder, Austin Shinhro, Kyle Weber, and Alex Yacobozzi. Please join me in congratulating our mentors. Elizabeth Becker. Elizabeth's hometown is Faulkner, New York. Her major is biology. And a fun fact, she loves doing nail art and even has a YouTube channel where she posts nail art tutorials. Lucienne Bello. Lucy's hometown is Warren, Pennsylvania. Her major is Spanish education. And her fun fact, she comes from a large family and she has 10 nieces and nephews who inspired her to go to the field of education. Quinn Cooley. Quinn's hometown is Lakeview, New York.
His major is psychology. And his fun fact, his parents chose the name Quinn while watching a Buffalo Bills game and seeing the Bills player Quinn early on the field. Trey Dietrich. Trey's hometown is Erie, Pennsylvania. His major is intelligence studies. And his fun fact, he likes long walks on the beach. Rebecca Dunphy. Rebecca's hometown is Stewartstown, Pennsylvania. Her major is dance and criminal justice with a concentration in pre-law. And her fun fact, she is a member of the Mercyhurst dance team. Summer Dutton. Summer's hometown is Ludlow, Massachusetts. Her majors are marketing and sports management. And her fun fact, she has never been to either Disney World or Disneyland. Emma Farrell. Emma's hometown is Hamburg, New York. Her major is undecided, but she's leaning towards business and psychology. Her fun fact, in her senior year, Emma competed at the Section 6 Swimming Championships with her record-breaking relay team to qualify for the New York State Swimming Championships. Bella Fragnoli. Bella's hometown is Hinckley, Ohio. Her major is intelligence studies with minors in French and political science with a focus in international relations. Her fun fact, she was a dancer for 14 years, 9 of which she studied classical ballet. Haley Huntley. Haley's hometown is St. Charles, Illinois. Her major is dance. And her fun fact, she was involved in jazz choir from her freshman year of high school into her senior year. Kadri Ismail. Kadri's hometown is Boca Raton, Florida. His major is graphic design. And his fun fact is he plays football, he is an Eagle Scout and a lifeguard, and he also cuts his own hair. Katie Johnston. Katie's hometown is Wilson, New York. Her majors are intelligence studies and political science. And her fun fact, after college, she hopes to move to Washington, D.C. Cheyenne Fine. Hometown is Painesville, Ohio. Her major is sports medicine and concentration in pre-PA. Her fun fact, over winter break, she studied abroad in France and Italy. Daisy Zwangle. Daisy's hometown is Hanoi, Vietnam. Her major is marketing with a communications minor. Her fun fact, when she went parasailing a few years ago, she was so lightweight that they could not get her down. She ended up waiting up there for a half an hour for the wind to die down. Ashley McWilliams. Education Assistant Studies. For fun fact, she loves to travel and has been to Italy. Joanne Pringle. Joanne's hometown is Altoona, Pennsylvania. Her major is early childhood education and special education. And her fun fact, when she was little, she wanted to be the first woman president. Addison Richard. Addison's hometown is North Collins, New York. Her major is interior architecture and design. And her fun fact, she lives on a dairy farm with over 400 cows. Lauren Rogas. Lauren's hometown is Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Her major is early childhood and special education, with a minor in art therapy. And her fun fact, one of her paintings, Hefty Heart, won a national award and then got chosen to go on tour to different states in the US. Nicole Rinnicki. Nicole's hometown is West Seneca, New York. Her major is early childhood and special education with a minor in criminal justice, concentrating on trade law. Her fun fact, she has a first degree black belt in Taekwondo. Katie Schneider. Katie's hometown is Erie, Pennsylvania. Her major is Intelligence Studies with an art minor. And her fun fact, she recently learned how to drag race. Jessica Skinker. Jessica's hometown is St. Louis, Missouri. Her major is dance. And her fun fact, she will be adding a second major in sports medicine for pre-occupational therapy and hopes to work with kids with disabilities when she is older. Grace Loop. Grace's hometown is Cleveland, Ohio. Her majors are accounting and business economics with a theater minor. And her fun fact, Grace has her own small photography business. Henley Spracklin. Henley's hometown is Erie, Pennsylvania. Her major is biology with a public health minor. Her fun fact, she loves working with animals and hopes to be a vet someday, and she interns at McCain Veterinary Hospital. Jeffrey Thompson. Jeff's hometown is Watertown, Connecticut. His major is undecided. Fun fact, he used to model for Wilhelmina, and one time he started to chase a cow, and the cow chased him back. Lauren Welling. Lauren's hometown is Elma, New York. Her major is Spanish, and her fun fact, her favorite Netflix series is Stranger Things. Nick Wall. Nick's hometown is Erie, Pennsylvania. His majors are religious studies and psychology, with a concentration in applied psychology and a minor in special education. His fun fact, he owns over 60 pairs of socks. Julia Rest. Julia's hometown is Albany, New York. Her major is intelligence studies. And her fun fact, she would like to go skydiving one day. Amina Yassifor. Amina's hometown is Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. Her major is forensic biology. And her fun fact, she helped run the Harrisburg Special Olympics for the past 4 years. Sydney Zajac. Sydney's hometown is Lancaster, New York. Her major is psychology. And her fun fact, she is one of four sisters. Will our new ambassadors please stand and turn, and let us all join in recognizing their achievements.
Please join me in congratulating the 2018 Ambassador Executive Board. Who are always ready and willing to help, even if it's not something ambassador related.
Sloan and Megan, we hope that you will never forget how special you are to us. So thank you again from the bottom of our hearts. Can you guys please come up here so we can give you some gifts? Many more years of being a student, Lynn would like to see the world by a husky puppy and maybe read the Harry Potter series again for the 7th time. Lynn's favorite ambassador memory would have to be serving the organization as pledge chair during the 2016-2017 pledge process. She enjoyed participating in the pledge process without the stress of actually pledging to be an ambassador all over again. Lynn truly loved working with her fellow ambassadors to teach the pledges about Mercy Earth's history and about the importance of keeping the legacy of the Sisters of Mercy alive.
Elizabeth Height, she is a dance major and plans to dance professionally and teach ballet. Her favorite ambassador memory was working as a scarer for Haunted Hearst on the third floor beacon with all the dance major pledges.
Robin Hoover. Robin's major is biology, neuroscience, and concentration. Her future plans, she plans to take a gap year to get a clinical experience in a hospital and then medical school. Her favorite ambassador memory is dressing up as the Annabelle doll for Haunted Hearst this year.
She wants to be a member of Congress. Her favorite ambassador memory was at Spring Open House 2 years ago after she gave a tour. The student committed to Mercyhurst and now Eliza sees the student around campus.
Datlick. Dat's major is hospitality management. His future plans is he's hoping to get a job in a hotel where he can learn more about the business. His favorite ambassador memory is when he came to talk to the children at Bethesda Children's Home about college experiences. He loved their excitement, their innocent questions, their dreams, and their stories. For a trip aiming at encouraging these kids to pursue a higher education in the future, he in return learned so much from their enthusiasm and positivity.
Caroline Mangano is in intelligence studies with a minor in information technology. Her future plans are to work for a government law enforcement agency as a federal agent with the ultimate goal of working for the Secret Service. Applications are still pending. Her favorite and best memory is working in the student panel Q&A and being able to share Mercier's experiences with other students.
Stephen Martz. Stephen's major is hospitality management with a concentration in event management. His future plans are to get a job in hospitality sales at a hotel in the DC area. His favorite ambassador memory is when a prospective student who just got a tour yelled across the outdoor classroom area in front of CERN Hall that she confirmed to come to Mercyhurst.
Jackie Miller. She is a hospitality management major with a dance minor. Her future plans are working at the coffee bar on campus, or working at the coffee bar on campus has inspired her to eventually open her own coffee shop. Her favorite ambassador memory was being a mentor. It brought her such joy when an eager mentee would ask to go on yet another practice tour or come to visit her at the coffee bar to run their speech one more time. She can proudly say that all of her mentees for both years have made it through, and two of them are now dating. She knows she has something to do with it.
Lily Morar. Lily's major is hospitality management with a concentration in hotel management. Her future plans, she accepted a position as the front desk supervisor at the Hotel Monaco. Her favorite ambassador memory is working as a social chair and then getting to plan special events for such an amazing group of people.
Mark Bollinger. He is a biology major with a minor in biochemistry. His future plans are to hope to go on to veterinary school. And his favorite ambassador memory is whenever he gets really positive feedback on the tour.
Brianna Misek. Bree's majors are accounting and finance. Her future plans are to continue to work with courses for one last summer and then get a job at an accounting firm. Her favorite ambassador memory. She has so many favorite memories from this amazing organization, but if she had had to choose one that sticks out the most, it would probably be the first time she received a letter from a girl she gave one of her first tours to freshman year. In her letter, she told Brianna how much she enjoyed the tour and said that seeing the school from Brianna's perspective was the reason she was choosing to attend Mercyhurst the following year instead of the other colleges she was looking at. And that's when Brianna knew that she loved being an ambassador.
Lindsay Rowe. Lindsay is an early childhood special education major and plans to stay at Mercyhurst for graduate school to receive her master's degree in special education with a concentration in applied behavior analysis. Her favorite ambassador memory is from her first ever tour. She was giving a tour to a large group of seventh graders, and while they were walking into the rec, she tripped over a large brick while walking backwards and completely ripped it. The kids didn't know whether to laugh or act like nothing happened, so she paused the tour just to tell them that they were allowed to laugh and that she embarrasses herself daily, so she didn't care if they made fun of her.
Carrie Sharrock. Carrie's major is dance with a minor in arts management. Her future plans are to dance professionally with a classical or contemporary ballet company. Her favorite ambassador memory is going to mass and brunch with the Sisters of Mercy at the House of Prayer downtown.
Pema Selden. Pema is an accounting and finance double major. She's currently contemplating her future plans, and her favorite ambassador memory is she remembers deciding to wear new shoes without breaking them in for one of her tours, and halfway through her tour, she could feel the pain. She knew her right foot was bleeding. However, since she was halfway through the tour, she decided to not show it and ended up barely managing to get through the tour. To this day, she still has a dime-sized scar on her right foot to remind her of that day, and she earned what it meant to truly seize the day.
Austin Shinrock. Austin's major is hospitality management. His future plans are he plans to attend graduate school in order to study higher education and work at a college or university. His favorite ambassador memory is seeing all the pledges he mentored getting their green jackets.
Sophia Thorman. Sophia is a dual major in dance and pre-health science. She plans on pursuing a master's degree in physician's assistant studies. And her favorite ambassador memory was having tea with the Sisters of Mercy in Ireland, even though it wasn't comfortable.
Tram Shrupp. Tram's major is she's a double major in finance and marketing. Her future plans are she will pursue her master's degree in finance in Australia. Her favorite ambassador memory would be that somehow it's always raining or snowing whenever she could move toward, but what warms her heart is that the families never seem to be bothered by that. They are always smiling and showing their enthusiasm, and it makes Tram feel really appreciated.
Morgan Wangler. Morgan is an early childhood and special education major with a French minor. Her future plans, first will still be home for Morgan for the next 2 years as she will be pursuing a master's degree in special education with a concentration in autism. During this time, she will also be serving as a graduate assistant through the Education Department as a teacher at St. Gregory School in Northeast Pennsylvania. After graduate school, she hopes to move out of the tundra and become an autistic support teacher in a warmer state, travel the world, and see the Pittsburgh Penguins win many more Stanley Cups. Her favorite ambassador memory, one of Morgan's all-time favorite memories, was when she was pledging in the fall of 2014 with her friends Lynn and Sarah. They were so nervous for the big ambassador test, so they recruited a friend that wasn't pledging to quiz them, and the three of them studied for roughly 18 hours in one weekend. By the time that test came, they could recite roughly every fact from Joe Howard's opening lecture, and luckily, all of them were accepted into the organization together. As a member of ambassadors, Morgan enjoyed serving as a mentor for the pledges for 2 years, and as the mentor chair for this current pledge class.
Alex Yacobozzi. Alex's major is hospitality management. His future plans are he plans to get a job with a sales and marketing team in the hospitality industry. His favorite ambassador memory is getting to work all summer with the admissions staff and some great ambassadors, even though he was late almost every other day.
Jacob Miller.
seniors please stand, and can we all please recognize their achievements?
Each year, Mercer's ambassadors are required to complete a minimum of 60 events. These events include giving prospective student tours, staffing admissions events, assisting with a multitude of other events put on by various departments at the university, and simply being ready and willing to do whatever needs to be done in service of the ambassador organization, Mercyhurst University, and ultimately, the Sisters of Mercy. Beyond giving tours and assisting with campus events, ambassadors are charged with preserving the history and legacy of the Sisters of Mercy. When one becomes an ambassador, there is an understanding that this is not a normal job where you are only on the clock when you're in your green jacket. Rather, an ambassador is on the clock, or on point, 24/7, from the first time they put on their green jacket at this ceremony, and one remains an ambassador for the rest of their life. While each and every ambassador in this room today fulfills our organization's mission with class, dignity, and professionalism, there are two ambassadors who truly stood out over the course of this year as exemplary role models for this organization. The first ambassador we are recognizing has brought a new spirit to this organization during his short time as an ambassador. He has shown us that it's okay to have fun and still be professional at the same time, which is a lesson I think many of us can learn from. Beyond his charm, wit, and unique sense of humor, this ambassador has always been more than willing to go above and beyond what is required of him. He truly encompasses all of our core values as a university, but specifically, our core value of being compassionately hospitable. I have never seen an ambassador who is better equipped at helping families feel welcome at our university than him. When speaking about this ambassador, the admissions staff had to say, "This ambassador has shown so much passion in his year of being an ambassador and has really made his mark on the program in a short amount of time. We only wish he had pledged sooner." The second ambassador we are recognizing has given this organization the utmost level of dedication during her time as an ambassador. This ambassador almost never lets a day go by without stopping into the admissions office to see how she can lend a hand. She has done this from the first day she became an ambassador, and even this semester as she entered retirement. By doing this, she has demonstrated a deep level of understanding for the fact that an ambassador is always an ambassador, whether or not they have any event requirements left to fulfill. Additionally, this ambassador was able to complete an entire year's worth of events in one semester in preparation for studying abroad last spring, which has made her quite the legend among ambassadors and admissions staff alike. When speaking about this ambassador, the admissions staff had to say, "She deserves this award for her hard work, dedication, and passion for the ambassador program and for Mercyhurst as a whole." Both of you have shown a deep and abiding respect for the traditions and legacy of the Sisters of Mercy through your passion, dedication, and hospitality. I think I speak for everyone in this room when I say that both of you will be sorely missed. Luckily for us, we only have to lose one of you this year. Please join me in congratulating our Ambassadors of the Year, Alex Iacobozzi and Sarah Brennan.
Congratulations.
recognition and thanks from Megan Huber. I have shared an office and worked side by side with her for almost 3 years, and in that time, I have come to respect her as a leader, admire her as a young professional, and truly like her as a co-worker and friend. When I started at Mercyhurst, Megan was president of the ambassador organization. And though that position comes with a host of responsibilities and duties, Megan, unknowingly, started taking on the role of graduate assistant as we had no GA at that time. We hadn't asked her to do this, nor expect her to, but that is who Megan is. Between her desire to be of service, as the Sisters of Mercy have taught us, and her love for the ambassador organization and Mercyhurst, she saw the opportunity to help, and so she did. She has helped to keep the ambassador organization running smoothly while serving as an ambassador herself, in and out of the blue jacket, in every interaction she has. She exemplifies what it means to be an ambassador of Mercyhurst. She has been such an asset to the admissions office, the ambassadors, and myself. Her abilities to multitask and manage time, her professionalism, and most importantly, her compassion and kindness for others has made Megan someone we will truly miss. But she has made her mark on Mercyhurst and the ambassador organization, and now it will soon be time for her to move on to the next chapter of her life and make her mark there. Megan, wherever your path leads you, whatever choices you make, we know you'll be guided by the same integrity and compassion that you displayed over and over in your 6 years of service to Mercyhurst. You will be leaving some very big shoes to fill. And as change is inevitable and time waits for no one, we sadly prepare ourselves to say goodbye to you. We gladly wish you all the success and happiness your future can possibly bring, and we most heartily send our love and thanks along with you. Megan, please join me to be recognized.
Let us pray. God of great love, as we conclude our gathering, we are reminded of our covenant relationship with you and the need to express that relationship through our outreach to those around us. It is indeed a blessing that we have young women and men who have come forth to fill the role of ambassador for Mercyhurst University. They exemplify everything that is good about this institution, and they send forth a message of care and concern to all with whom they come in contact. We ask your blessing on those newly installed ambassadors, those whose service is coming to an end, and those who continue to serve the campus community. Mindful of your constant presence in our lives, we ask your blessing upon their parents, Keep all of us ever mindful of our roles as disciples and ambassadors for your Son, Jesus Christ. We thank you for the many blessings you have bestowed on this institution, and we ask your continued blessing in all things that are right and true. May the Creator who made us, the Redeemer who saves us, and the Sanctifier who empowers us, bring us ever closer to our authentic identity in this life and in the life to come. Amen.
At this time, I would like to call ambassadors Brianne Colligan, Lane Jalot, and Jacob Tretnik to share their talents and help us celebrate the tradition of singing the Ambassador Song. We would also like to invite the graduating ambassadors to come forward and the entire ambassador organization to stand, turn, and face our families and friends as we sing the Ambassador Song.
Thank you.